I get asked all the time how I did this on my website or how I did that on my website, and I'm going to try to answer as many of those in this video. So if you've been to my website and you want to know how I did something, I'm going to answer it right now. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies, and this is my website. And I actually kind of made a lot of this from scratch. The layout and everything is just stuff that's floating around in my head, but my website is constantly in this changing evolution thing. So if you look at my website snapshot every month for the last, say, 2 or 3 years, it probably will look a little different every single time. So I'm going to try to answer these questions and tell you some of the things that I'm running on my website. So one of the things I get asked a lot is I've got this sign in button right here, and when you click on it, it has this really beautiful, elegant pop up so someone can sign into my website. And this makes it easy because I have a learning management system, so it's real easy for them to log in. But really, I think why people like it is because it looks pretty darn cool, and I can actually change a lot of the colors on here, and I can make it however I want. I just left it at this. Unfortunately, you can't buy a plugin for this. It's actually part of my theme. This is the theme that I'm using right now. It's called Newspaper, and it's available on ThemeForest. I'll have links to everything down below, and it's going to allow me to do... Wow, it's actually on sale right now. It's only $39. It's normally, I think, $59, but it's on sale right now. That's actually a really good price, but normally it's $59. And this gives me lots of features to my website that there just might not even be plugins available to do. So that is one of them right there, is this really slick sign-in. Another thing that's cool is there's this search button here, but as you type, it's going to start showing suggestions. So if I type the word backup, there it is. I just entered in the word backup, and it's already showing me some suggestions, and it does that as well. I really like that feature. Another thing that this does is it allows me to have these really nice video playlists. So if you look at this new video series, How to Create an Online Course Website, when you click on it, I'm going to have to pause it. Okay, there we go. I paused it. It allows me to make this really nice looking video playlist where here's the video playing, and I can scroll down here and I can easily add a bunch of videos, and it always shows the title here of the one that's playing, and it's very nice. It allows me to customize these colors. This, unfortunately, as well, is a feature specific to this theme. It's actually very easy to create a playlist like this, and I really like the way that it looks. It's one of my favorite things about this theme, honestly, is really this video playlist. Of course, the click to log in is really nice as well. And it allows you all these different header layouts where I can have this navigation in different locations. And there's also a bunch of footer layouts. And it also does this style that you see here. There's 10 different styles. It's an okay theme. I really like it. And it does come bundled with Visual Composer, which is optional, and I don't have that part installed, and I don't use that part on my website. And so, okay, so the next thing that I get asked all the time is, how do I do this scrolling text bit right here? Well, that is actually very easy. This is a feature that comes in a plugin I have installed called Ultimate Add-ons for Beaver Builder. So all the pages on this website I built using Beaver Builder, and there's this add-on package called Ultimate Add-ons for Beaver Builder, and it allows me to do things like this. And this specifically is called Fancy Text, and so I could have this live typing option if I wanted. I didn't want that. Here's another example of that without the blinking thing. And then here's the one that I have where this just rotates, and you can put as many as you want in there, and you can set the speed. You can do all kinds of cool things like that. And I think you can also change the color of what scrolls. But what's nice about Ultimate Add-ons is when I click on modules, there's module after module after module. There's all these awesome modules and features that it adds for the one low price. Now, I do talk a lot about Elementor. I love Elementor. And so people that see my Elementor videos might say, why aren't you using Elementor? You talk about it all the time. And the answer is simple. I also talk about Beaver Builder all the time. It's just Elementor is newer. When I built my website and really got in the nitty-gritty of building it, Elementor wasn't even around. So it doesn't really make any sense for me to switch from Beaver Builder to Elementor unless I was redoing everything on the website, which I don't plan to do. I do have websites using Elementor. I do love it. I do use it. It's just on this site, I am using Beaver Builder because it's what I have always used. And so that is how I am doing this scrolling text. And I also use the ultimate add-ons for Beaver Builder and Beaver Builder to also make my recommended page. I put a lot of effort into this recommended page right here where I have all the different products that I'm personally using. And I made this design layout myself. And that's the beauty of one of these page builder plugins. You can literally see anything on the internet and build it yourself, which I think is tremendously powerful. And I really love Beaver Builder and Elementor for that power. Another thing you can see here is that sticky menu. You see that? That's pretty cool, huh? Just like that. I actually made a video on how to do this. You can make anything sticky like that. I like it because I can just make it so my visitors, if they want to see WordPress themes, they can click on that. If they want to see this, they can click on that and they can scroll right back up to the top. And I just did that very easily with this free plugin. I do have a video on that. I think it's called Sticky Something or whatever. And you can make anything stick, but I actually have a video on how to use it. Now, the next thing I get asked a lot, let me go to my homepage, is how on earth did I get these social buttons like this? And this is actually a real easy one. This is a plugin called Social Warfare. Now, the problem with choosing a social button, whatever, for your website is there's a lot of options out there. And unfortunately, what ends up happening is these are high maintenance plugins. And what that means is if someone's going to come out with a social media button plugin, they're going to have to be on top of it because the social networks are always changing things and the connections get broken and there's all these little things that happen. And so the reason I use this one is because it's a paid plugin. It's real cheap. It's like $30 or something like that. But if you start paying attention to all the very popular bloggers or internet personalities and you keep going to these websites, you're going to notice they're all using this same plugin called Social Warfare. I'll have a link down below to this. Let's actually take a quick look at the price. What I like about it is that it gives you a lot of design control, but I like for instance, right now, it'll stick the buttons to the bottom. I kind of like that a lot. And there's different ways that you can style these buttons. It's just a really nice package. It's right here. It's only $29 to have this on your website. Now, I'm not saying run out and buy this for $29. I am saying it's the social media buttons that I personally use, and I really like it. There's other social media button options out there. There's some free ones in the WordPress repository, but what I notice is these plugins, they come and then they go. So if you're going to get one of these free ones and you're going to put it in there, it might be gone in a year, outdated, it doesn't work anymore, and you're going to have to switch anyway. And that's probably actually what happened with Social Warfare. It's really a situation where they just built a better mousetrap. There were plenty of really popular ones. I think one was called Flare. Everyone had Flare on their website. And now no one has Flare on the website because they don't even develop it anymore. They just stopped. Or I don't know the full story behind it. But Social Warfare is pretty awesome. And that is what a lot of people are going to now. The next thing is on some of these, let me go back to this page right here and I'll pause it. I generate pop-ups. Now, I don't abuse pop-ups. I don't show you pop-ups when you come to my site, leave my site, or go to specific pages on my site. The only pop-ups I'm really using, and I'm probably underutilizing pop-ups. So when you come to here and I have a download for downloading some resources and you click click on this button, I generate this really beautiful light box pop-up with this contact form. Now, what I'm using for this is Thrive Leads. I've always been a fan of Thrive Leads. I've always recommended Thrive Leads. I only scratched the surface on what this thing can do. I should actually do a full video training on it. If you are thinking of adding pop-ups to maybe generate leads or to capture people's email information or to deliver some freebie that you're emailing, I'll let you know right now, don't look any further. Thrive Leads is the only game in town. It really is. There are other ones, but they pale in comparison. Nothing has even ever come close to what Thrive Leads can do for you. So it's even used on John Lee Dumas's website. He's a very well-known podcaster, very successful. The feature set that you get is just completely comprehensive and completely amazing. All the different opt-in elements you can create with this, it's just outstanding what you can do with Thrive Leads. Nothing even comes close. And so that's how I'm generating these various pop-ups that you might see on any of my websites that you might visit. There's another thing that you're actually not going to see on my site right now. It's only appearing sometimes, and I'm sure you might have been to my website and you see a notice here on the bottom. Maybe I might be having a promotion on something, or I'm discounting a price or whatever, and you'll see it slide up and there's a countdown timer. Well, I use probably the most amazing plugin for it. No one's even tried to make anything to compete. It's called Thrive Ultimatum, and it allows you to have these scarcity offers when people come to your website. And let me see if it shows you any kind of demo of it. Oh yeah, so you can create these different offers. So you can have it slide from the bottom to the top. You can integrate it in your content. There's lots of different ways that you can use this. This is probably the most powerful plugin of its kind. There's some things I don't like about it, but it's totally worth living with it because of the power that it brings to your website. It's just outstanding. If you sell anything on your website or market anything or have any kind of products or anything like that, you really need to take a look at this plugin and see how you can integrate it into your business and on your website. It's pretty fantastic. So, you know, that is pretty much everything. Everything that you see that I didn't explain, like this grid, it's all done with Ultimate add-ons for Beaver Builder, with Beaver Builder. So if I didn't explain it in this video, it was definitely Beaver Builder. You know, to facilitate all these courses, I use Lifter LMS, and I have my whole video series on Lifter LMS. You know, the live chat right now, I'm using Talk2, TAWK.TO. It's a free live chat application. And I think that about does it. That covers everything that I'm using on my website. I'm going to go ahead and put links down below. And if you noticed, I do prefer to use things that you have to pay for. And the reason why, I'm not saying you have to, everything you use you actually bought. What I'm saying is I prefer commercial software where I know it's going to be supported, updated. If there's a problem, I've got someone to go to and complain to, versus if I used everything that was free, or if I made a video on all these free alternatives, if something broke, I'm going to be losing out big time because I don't have dedicated support. Someone I can go to and say, hey, rattle their cage. Hey, I need help. That's why everything I use, I paid for. I paid for my theme. I paid for my page builder. Every single thing I listed, I pretty much paid for. But it's money well spent to support these developers and also to have reliable stuff on my website that's going to make me look professional. God forbid if you came to my website and something was broken, it would look really, it would reflect really badly on me, and that's something that I never want. So anyways, I'll have links to everything below. If you have more specific questions that I didn't answer in this video, I am thrilled to answer them for you. I'd go ahead and leave those down in the comment section down below. And if you think there's any suggestions that you have for me of things that I can add to my website to make it better, go ahead and add that down below. I'd love to hear your thoughts and opinions. Hey, thanks for watching this video.